Hello there folks, these are the hands of me, Dan Brown, from Sort of Interesting, and this, as you can tell, is a rather nice little multi-tool, pen knife, whatever you want to call it. It's from Leatherman, so you know it's going to be good. So first of all, we'll have a very quick look at the box, but it's pretty much as simple and straightforward as you would expect. And this, my friends, is the Leatherman Blast. So, let's pop it out. We'll go through the less exciting things first. First of all, obviously you need a sticker with any new product. Then you've got your belt clip and holder. And it's got to be said, because this is such a compact tool, it's not as bulky and sort of in the way as I thought it would be, as I've already had that on my belt and forgot that it was there for a day. So that's a very good sign. Then, obviously, you've got your incredible list of instructions. And I don't know, I suppose it's the heads-up guide of what exactly you've got on these tools. But, what we really want to see, and what we are all here for, is the Leatherman Blast itself. Now, this, as you can see, is a very nicely made compact tool, and it's got to be said, I really can't say how good quality and how solid this feels. I mean, you can tell, once you've bought something quality, you know that it's good, and this is definitely one of those cases. Right, I suppose we'll have a quick close-up here first before we open it up. And as you can see there, it's got a little custom engraving on, Damn Narrowboat Lad. Yes, I do live out on a narrowboat, and that's the title of my book as well. So that's a nice quick plug there. And if we flip it over, then it's pretty much what you would expect. But the real excitement begins when we zoom back out and start seeing what exactly we have got on here. So then, as we open this up, we've got the first and most obvious tool, which is a pair of pliers. And it's also interesting to note these are needle nose pliers. Then, keeping it in a similar theme, we've got wire cutters at the back there, and there's a very slight depression in each of the blades at the very back of it, which are listed as hard wire cutters, but I'm not entirely certain what that what the difference is, so I'll let experts concern themselves with that. And really, it's time to dive into what we really want to see. So, first of all, we've obviously got the knife, and something that's nice about this, and once again, speaking of the quality of this and how solid everything feels, is that you've got this part here that allows tools such as the knife to really solidly clip into place. And then to put them back down, you obviously then have got to press that, which releases it. And obviously here, you want to be extremely careful when handling a very sharp knife. So that's the knife, and that's the clip element of this tool. Then coming up, keeping it in a cutting theme, we've obviously got ourselves a nice little saw, and once again, it's just like I say, the quality of this, and the fact that they can all clip so solidly in place, which then means in turn, you can close up the handle, so that you've got like a proper sort of grip on it. It's just fantastic. So, moving back up, what else have we got here? We've got ourselves a nice big wide screwdriver there, then we've got a medium screwdriver, and what is described as a small bit driver. As you can see there, that is very small indeed. Flipping over now to the other side, if I can find a good camera angle to try and keep all this in view. What have we got here? Right, starting up here, fantastic. Little pair of scissors, lovely jubbly. And of course, those have also got a little spring to make sure that they act as sensible scissors, because you can't obviously keep opening them with your hands because there's no grips for your thumb and fingers to go through. So that's fantastic as usual. Coming up next, we've got a file. And I think this is two separate, I think those are both different levels of coarseness on there. Certainly feels that way at least. Then we've got, coming up, I'm starting to run out of room here. We've got a crosshead screwdriver there. And that goes down to a pretty small point. It's not a tiny miniature screwdriver point like, well, for example, the tiny bit there. But that should be useful for most crosshead screws. And of course, what else could you have? What tool would be complete without a bottle opener? And also, as part of the bottle opener, I couldn't figure out what exactly it was at first. But just along there, it's another sort of blade cut in at an angle. And that is a wire stripper. So you've certainly got plenty of stuff covered on this tool. So if I fetch this up for a closer look so you can really get a good view of it, then you can see there the pliers and wire cutters coming down. You can see obviously all the different features on that side. And well, like I say, it's just the build quality that I'm most impressed with. I mean, it's packing an awful lot of features into a very small tool. And this is a lot smaller than other tools that I've seen that are, well, I don't wish to name brands, but of a less significant quality. And well, like I say, there's plenty on here. It's extremely good quality. And it all ultimately folds up into a very nice little package. So if we put this back and see once again just how it all clips into place. And being extremely careful handling the knife there. Like I say, you can't really ask for much more than that. So thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned and check out my other videos. Make sure you subscribe for a lot more general sort of outdoorsy stuff. I live on a boat, as noted with the narrowboat lad engraving there. And so that brings a lot of outdoor videos and it might interest you. Thank you very much for watching once again. Make sure you subscribe, like the Facebook page. Feel free to follow me on Twitter or add my personal Facebook account. And really, have a fantastic day and I will see you around soon. Farewell.